is when you endure. The devil actually shuts down. It said the devil flee from him.
All right.
And whether he come back or not, I still know what to do.
Right.
Walk on by
faith.
Keep walking.
Yes.
Don't let the trials and tribulations of this life,
all right,
and brothers to trouble,
yes,
cause you to be left in the gold mine. And the diamond mine,
yes,
with filth all over you.
Yes.
Something that nobody wants to have. What does it have to do with it? It's a fire,
yes, sir,
that burns it off.
All right.
It's a fire that makes you ready and brave.
Thank you.
It's a fire that puts you in the consolation of the believers,
yes,
in the Word of God.
Yes.
Come right now. If you're here and you still have just a centimeter of stuff that should have been burnt off,
all right,
by now,
yes,
come now and just let the power of the Holy Ghost,
right, yes, sir,
put you in a new setting.
Yes, sir.
That you stretch your arms.
Yes.
You can live a Christian life. I thought I would never be able to say that. I've been preaching for 47 years.
Yes.
You can live a Christian life. You're gonna stop. You wanna have something that will get to you.
Yes, sir.
But when you live a faith life, you know that there is repentance.
Yes.
And you don't walk around saying, I ain't done nothing, I still go to church. You've got to live by faith.
Amen.
And faith will tell you to ask the Lord to send you in another direction.
Yes.
Another direction might be not to position your fist to where you want to hit somebody. That's another direction. But this old sinful frame gets so, I told you, it was a Bible study. It 3 hours after I got preached, I wanted to beat somebody up. And I call myself a preacher and a pastor. I call myself, I am. But this old sinful nature stays around. So I've got to live a life of faith to know that God is a forgiving God. But I've got to accept responsibility for my actions and not just go to God. I'm still alright. I also slipped. Some residents, some crash got into your diamond.
Yes.
I know you've been asking, you've been trying to do that ever since we preached on the sermon, love your enemies. I've done some additional study. I've been praying. And maybe even while this auditorium is not full, or has never been full. Because I've been asking you to do something that you'll never be able to do. face them. He would have stayed, been in the grave. Yes, he was dead.
Jesus.
But he came to make sacrifice for you and me.
All right.
And died with the faith and the trust that God would do as he promised. And he always does. So, son of God, we now know that the sacrifice of his death was